Good morning, everybody. Today, I'm going to be translating the morning conference as long as I can until I have to go to work. And then, hopefully, you won't miss anything really good. Okay, so I'm going to take the title off for now. Let's see. Okay. And we'll go ahead and start with the president talking here. Let's see. Right about when he comes in, I would say right about there. Okay. So, this isn't too far into it. Oh, there he comes. Okay.
Animo.
And he says, cheer up.
Buenos días, se hizo tarde.
Hello, because it got a little
late. Pero ya estamos aquí.
But we're here now.
Hoy vamos a dar a conocer lo que se ha hecho para atender a los familiares de las víctimas de Tlahualilpan que perdieron la vida en una explosión. Lamentablemente, mañana se cumple un año y queremos informar lo que se está llevando a cabo con ellos, porque fue muy doloroso. Considero que fue lo más triste que hemos padecido desde que estamos en el gobierno. Muy lamentable. Lo que sucedió y pues tenemos el compromiso de seguir atendiendo las causas de fondo, sobre todo la desatención, el abandono a la gente, la desatención, el abandono a los pueblos, a las familias, a los jóvenes. Se fue creando con el paso del tiempo en esto del robo de combustible, pero en todo, una subcultura, si se le puede llamar de esa manera, o un proceder de informalidad, de ilegalidad,
and of illegality,
de buscarse la vida como fuese y al mismo tiempo arriesgar la vida para sobrevivir.
Trying to make a living and risking their life.
Esto de el huachicol,
this thing called huachicol, which is
es producto de la desatención, de no dar opciones, de no dar alternativas, desde luego manejado por grupos de delincuentes, pero con una base social de apoyo. Y se había convertido
and it had become converted.
Una práctica.
In practice.
El destruir un ducto.
They would destroy a duct.
Hacer una toma clandestina.
And then they would steal
extraer gasolina.
Gas extracted.
Los jefes.
And the chief.
Los de las bandas. Llevarse pipas.
They would bring the pipe,
distribuir la gasolina,
and they would distribute the gasoline,
sacar mayor provecho,
and they
y a la gente
take as much
de las comunidades, de los pueblos por donde pasan los ductos, donde están las tomas, dejarles algo, hacer zanjas para ir recoger combustible y vender el combustible. Y esto,
and they would steal the gas,
como un ingreso,
and that became like an income
para la sobrevivencia,
so that they could survive.
Con la tolerancia de las autoridades, porque ellos estaban también haciendo lo mismo, nada más que con otro tipo de actividades. También huachicol, pero en contratos, en sobornos.
Suborning.
Entonces los like de abajo, viendo
they
que esto sucedía arriba, no sentían ninguna mortificación, ninguna culpa.
Like they were doing
si lo hacen arriba, porque nosotros no.
If they were doing it above,
si no nos dan nada, si estamos abandonados.
And we've been abandoned.
Entonces,
so therefore,
esto llevó
this became,
a esta situación tan difícil y esta tragedia. Y todavía
and still, to this day,
seguimos
we continue,
padeciendo de este robo,
having this theft,
ya no como antes.
Not like before,
por eso me detengo a hablar sobre el tema, porque sigue habiendo huachicol en
Hidalgo,
ahí donde fue la tragedia. Es el estado con más tomas clandestinas. Segundo lugar, el Estado de México. Pero Hidalgo notoriamente es el que tiene más.
It's the most. They are stealing the most from Hidalgo.
Actos de robo de combustible.
With the theft of combustible.
Entonces es un llamado a todos,
so
a la población en general,
to the population generally,
a las comunidades que
the community,
viven cerca de los ductos.
That live near the ducts.
No es lo que se roben de combustible, son las vidas. Es un riesgo altísimo. Hemos estado enfrentando fugas de gas por el robo de gas. Le tenemos que desalojar a poblaciones completas.
We've had to clear out complete
hemos actuado con rapidez los trabajadores de Pemex, los
Pemex,
técnicos que se dedican a esto de protección civil, han estado muy atentos, han aplicado a fondo.
They have been more attentive applying.
Han hecho muy bien su trabajo.
Yeah,
y además hemos
well.
Corrido con suerte.
And we've also had luck.
Porque han habido casos de mucha gravedad, de mucho riesgo. Entonces, es un llamado a toda la población a que cuidemos este asunto
of this matter.
Y
and
el compromiso nuestro de seguir dando opciones alternativas a los jóvenes, que no falten los apoyos, que haya trabajo.
Support,
lo hemos dicho
and we've said it before.
En otras ocasiones, lo repito ahora, el que argumente
that one that gives an argument,
que tiene que hacer estas actividades o se ve obligado a actuar de esa forma porque no tiene empleo, que nos informe. Tenemos nosotros manera de emplearlo. Nada más les informo, hay 900,000 jóvenes en el programa Jóvenes Construyendo el Futuro,
program,
que están trabajando como
life.
Aprendices.
They're studying as apprentices.
Ahora que aumentó el salario mínimo,
and now the minimum
y
salary went
ya es
up.
De más de 3,600 pesos mensuales,
and now
ya di la instrucción que todos los jóvenes de el programa Jóvenes Construyendo el Futuro van a recibir, van a tener, creo que son como 170 pesos
para additional.
Que reciban el salario mínimo,
so that they can
porque
be
ya se quedó
wage.
Abajo
now it fell below it.
La cantidad de los 3,600 pesos. Ahora estuvimos viendo lo de migrantes.
And now regarding the immigrants,
vienen en caravana,
and they're coming in
migrantes,
caravan,
porque seguramente me lo van a preguntar,
and of course
de Honduras, de El Salvador,
from Honduras and El Salvador.
Alrededor de 3,000,
around 3,000 of them,
de 2,500 a 3,000,
or 2,500 to 3,000.
Unos que quieren entrar por Tapachula,
someone
otros por El Ceibo,
Tapachula,
Tenosique, Tabasco.
Tenosique, Tabasco.
Tenemos más de 4,000 empleos.
And we have more than 4,000 jobs there.
En la frontera sur.
At the border.
Disponibles.
Border.
Desde luego, albergues
course,
y
also, places for them to
atención
stay,
médica,
medical attention,
todo.
Everything.
Pero trabajo.
But also work. Jobs.
En nuestro país.
In
our se ofrece
country.
Eso.
We are offering that.
Y lo mismo para nuestros connacionales.
And also the same for our connationals.
Hay manera
that there is a way
de que tengan trabajo.
That they can have a job.
Mi ideal es empleo pleno.
My idea is
trabajo a
lots
todos.
Of work, jobs for everybody.
El trabajo o el derecho
the work
al trabajo.
Or the right to work.
Que se garantice.
Needs to be guaranteed.
Entonces, vamos a escuchar la exposición
so we're gonna listen
de
to
Diana Álvarez, que es
of,
la subsecretaria de Gobernación,
the
que ha estado dedicada
that has been
a atender
to attending
a los familiares
the family members
de los que perdieron la vida
of those that lost their
en
lives
la explosión
in the
de Tlahuelilpan. También nos va a informar David León y aquí me gustaría que les explicaras de los casos de gas, de los más difíciles y la técnica que se utiliza. A lo mejor tienen por ahí algún video sobre lo de la técnica. Una vez expuso algo. Y el maestro Román Meyer, que también va a estar aquí, por las intervenciones urbanas, por lo que se hace de obras en beneficio de las comunidades. Bueno, pues le dejamos la palabra a Diana.
Con su permiso, señor presidente. Muy buenos días a todas y todos. Vamos a hacer un informe anual de lo que hasta la fecha hemos estado haciendo y recordando desde luego estos trágicos sucesos del 18 de enero de 2019 en que explotó este ducto ubicado en Tlahuelilpan, Hidalgo. Por encomienda presidencial se acudió a dar personalmente las condolencias a familiares de las víctimas y ofrecer apoyo humanitario por parte del Gobierno de México y de su presidente. Acudí a visitar a las familias de manera personal en sus domicilios, pero también en iglesias, en escuelas y en otros espacios públicos donde nos pudimos reunir y platicar sobre esta situación. Identificamos problemáticas específicas que nos ayudaron posteriormente a tomar decisiones inmediatas y también a mediano y largo plazo, como el fallecimiento de sostenes económicos de familia, la muerte de varios integrantes.
Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and read this because she's reading it in very rapidly in Spanish. Okay, so I'll translate it as I read it. It says, on the 18th of January 2019, a duct, or it's a pipeline, exploded that was under Tejuelpan, Hidalgo. And by the recommendation of the president, we went personally to attend to the families of the victims and offer support, humanitarian support from the government or on behalf of the government and its president. We visited the families directly at their homes and in churches, schools, and other spaces, public spaces, because there also there were parks and public cultural centers so that they could register their victims. The problems that were specifically detected were the following: that there was a death of the sometimes the one that was the most economically providing for the family, that there was a death of several people in the same family, that we had lots of widows and orphans, and there was a change in the roles. Now the widow is the only one at home, and she has to take care of everything personally. And the man, who was a widow, had to take care of everything at home as well as out, you know, take care of his kids and be able to try and support them. And so there were adults, older adults, that were dependent on some of these young people that lost their lives.
De la misma familia, viudez y orfandad y cambio repentino de roles, por ejemplo, amas de casa que enviudaron y que no tenían ningún empleo, ninguna formación, o el viudo también trabajador que se quedó sin preparación para la crianza de los hijos, y adultos mayores que eran dependientes de sus hijos y que quedaron como responsables de los menores. Tenemos aquí también los datos definitivos, 69 personas que fallecieron.
And so she says, here we have the definitive data that there was these people that died. Let's see, there was 69 persons. Wait, what does it say? Deceased, 68 died in the hospital. So 69 died on site. And then let's see, what is this? Hospitalized, and then youth 13. Wow. So 12 to 17 year olds, there were 16. 18 to 29, there were 61. 30 to 49 year olds, there were 63. 50 to 65, there were 10. So a total of 150 deaths. And that is what she's going to tell you about. So I'm going to move it just past that.
Y adultos mayores que eran dependientes de sus hijos y que quedaron como responsables de los menores. Científica, lo cual pues le da mucha tranquilidad a todos estos familiares. La que sigue. Se creó entonces una coordinación interinstitucional. Para comentar que la Secretaría de Seguridad Pública y Protección Ciudadana participó para que se lograran la identificación de todas las personas fallecidas.
So they had a organization or part a group agency that helped them identify all the bodies of their family members so that they could know for sure if they were killed.
Hubo la creación de un protocolo de entrega de los fallecidos a sus familiares.
And they also started a new protocol to turn over the dead to the family so they could give their respects, their last respects.
Y se capacitaron a todos los elementos de los servicios periciales. Se le apoyó a la fiscalía en todo el proceso para...
So they also helped with the agency with children, and they helped the police agencies with anything that they needed.
Identificar y entregar los cuerpos y...
So that they could identify and turn over the body.
Todo esto a través de elementos del área científica, lo cual...
And so they used the scientific area in order to identify the family members.
Pues le da mucha tranquilidad a todos estos familiares.
And so this gave a lot of peace to the family members that couldn't be sure.
Familiares. La que sigue.
Now you got to remember, this explosion left some people with just smithereens. And so they didn't know for sure if they were maybe just out somewhere or necessarily killed in that explosion until the police, with the scientists and forensics, they were able to say for a certainty that certain people had died and, you know, had the familial tests, you know, genetics to know for sure that it was their family. So it was quite intensive, and they did that in order to give them peace.
Se creó entonces una coordinación interinstitucional encabezada por Gobernación y por estas dependencias que...
So then they created an agency that headed all the other agencies.
Aquí se enumeran para acercarse a esta comunidad y empezar a dar los diferentes apoyos. Quiero también mencionar que entonces...
So they did this in order to be able to get close to this community and be able to give them the support that they might need.
Todo lo que se hizo, se ha trabajado y se ha colaborado y se ha hecho un trabajo coordinado con el gobierno del estado de Hidalgo, a quien le agradecemos mucho también por este apoyo. En cuanto a las acciones...
So they said that they also worked with the state of Hidalgo and that they appreciate their support in working in coordination with them. Unfortunately, they did not do a close-up of that sheet behind her on the wall or the slide. But she said that all these groups came together under the heading of another group in order to make sure that all the needs of the people that were affected by that explosion would have the support that they needed.
Inmediatas, quisiera comentar que en primer lugar se atendió para que se pudiera verificar y llevar a cabo un registro de los familiares que estuvieran hospitalizados.
Okay, so she said that they went through and did a verification so that they could register the identification of family members, that they had therapy, they did religious and therapeutic mental health type things to support them through the grieving process. They did coordinated funeral supports where the national government helped them pay for the funerals. They did amplification of the grave site. They made a bigger, what do you call that place where you bury people? The where all the plots are. I can't think of the name. Oh my gosh. But anyway, so they made that place where you would put all the bodies bigger. They amplified that, and they also gave humanitarian support. They gave them money for expenses. They helped the ones that were vulnerable, the ones that had children. They give 15,000 pesos to the families of the people that died, and they paid for hospitalization, and or if someone just was disappeared, you know, after that. So they gave the money to them.
Desaparecidos o fallecidos, hubo también apoyo terapéutico coordinado tanto con grupos religiosos, implementando centros de escucha y atención a familiares, pero las acciones del gobierno tuvieron que ver justamente con la verificación de las listas, los datos de las personas.
So the thing that the government had to do was go in and verify the list to make sure that you know, they had all the people that had died and also to verify that they were actually involved.
Contacto con familiares, crear una base de datos, hacer visitas domiciliarias para.
So they had to create a base of data, visit the families,
verificar y completar.
To verify and complete the process.
El censo y posteriormente poder bajar los apoyos federales.
And then also to do the census and to be able to apply the financial support from the federal government.
Adelante. Además del apoyo humanitario de 15 mil pesos, los apoyos funerarios, inmediatamente se estableció el censo para las
víctimas. So she said that besides the turning over the bodies, they also paid for funeral services, and they gave grants for well-being, and it says they gave grants to the children and the parents that were working. And they had money for the chiefs of family. In other words, if they were the head of household, they got a grant. Let's see. And then there was a pension for well-being for the older adults, so they got like a retirement type fund so that the elderly would now have someone to support them. Because remember, some of the young people that were supporting the elder adults lost their lives, which the government is now giving support to anybody that's 68 or over anyway. But I guess these people, because of the death of their families, got some money anyway. And they're having reproductive options, which means implementation of and supports of, I'm sorry, not reproductive, productive, so that they help them get, you know, like be able to somehow be able to support their family. Jobs, maybe, you know, it doesn't say specifically, but it says that they figured sustaining economics and ambient. So it could have been anything like, you know, the planting trees, planting food, whatever it takes.
Becas de Benito Juárez, que son apoyos para la educación inicial.
So then, yeah, they're talking about the grants for the children. They gave them grants so that they could have for education. So that's another new thing that they did, is that they're giving financial support to anybody who has someone in school. They all get grants so that they are able to buy clothing and food, because they say that children cannot learn if they're starving. So hopefully the parents are using the money appropriately and making sure that they're feeding their children and, you know, getting their school clothes and all that.
Básica, media y superior, niñas y niños de madres trabajadoras, que son para
orfandad. Because remember, I have to go to work. I'm sorry, but I'm not going to be able to put a lot of attention.
Montiel, algunos también reuniones con los familiares.
And this is where they meet with the family.
El 19 de marzo tuvimos una reunión con un comité de familias que acudió a Palacio Nacional, en donde surgió el primer compromiso para gestionar la compra del terreno para la construcción del memorial. Es importante.
Okay, so on the 13th of March, she said, I believe, that they family members went to the National Palace, or in Mexico, where the president was. They had a meeting with him, and that's where he told them he was going to be buying the land or paying for the land in order to make a monument for the family members that were lost, so that there'll be a remembrance of them that this tragedy happened at.
Es importante mencionar también que en enero, inmediatamente, los familiares solicitaron también que hubiera una cancelación del canal de riego que pasaba por el lugar.
And so the family members in January asked that there be a cancellation of the river that was put through their that area in order to, or like a canal probably, in order to irrigate the land.
Del siniestro, dado que ahí se encontraban todas las cenizas y los restos de sus familiares.
And they didn't want those going out because the remains of their family and their loved ones' ashes also were in that water or in that stream.
Y era muy importante conservarlas. Así es que.
And they wanted to conserve it. So what actually there is a river, and they did not want those remains to be put out in the field, you know, so they wanted water to be diverted from somewhere else and not the river that passed right by their house.
Con agua llevó a cabo un recorrido y posteriormente firmó un convenio también con SADER y llevaron a cabo estas obras respectivas, en donde podemos ver en la siguiente lámina que
so
se construyó un sifón.
Where they redirected the river so that it no longer was, you know, the one that they were using for irrigation, they redirected it. On these pictures, you can see that they,
la desviación del canal, la construcción del nuevo canal de riego,
for a new canal for irrigation,
que logró la preservación de todas estas cenizas.
And this allowed them to preserve the remains and ashes of their family members in their area.
¿Qué sigue? En cuanto a la adquisición de terrenos destinados al memorial, la Secretaría de Gobernación gestionó con el apoyo de Pemex, Indavin, desde luego el propietario.
So this is where they're talking about the acquisition of the land, where they're going to be putting the memorial for those people. And it was by the Secretary of the Government and Pemex. They bought the land for the construction of, or bought, or some, yeah, it says bought the land so that they could put the memorial there. And they, let's see, and they did preparation of the land for the monument, and they gave the proposal of the cost, and you know what they were going to do, like a plan for the people or the government of that state, so that they can approve what they had planned to do. And then Pemex acquired a property and a construction and memorial permit in October 2019, and they will be creating an immovable structure there in the municipality of Tepiclan, or Teocalpan. It's the only purpose is to have the land to be used exclusively for the memorial.
Del inmueble, la compra, la fiscalía pudo levantar para ellos y sus familiares y sus jóvenes. Así es que se decidió reiniciar con un programa de reconstrucción del tejido social.
So they decided to start a new program to help with the social fiber, fabric, you know, the moral fabric of the area.
A partir de primero conversatorios, que son pláticas de análisis y de reflexión.
So they're going to be having talks that deal with reflection and analysis.
Con diferentes temas, uno fue.
With different matters.
Dos fueron en septiembre, uno octubre, otro en diciembre.
They had two of those meetings in October and one in December.
Se trataron temas con respecto justamente a la convivencia en comunidad, el tejido social, las instituciones locales.
So they talked about all these different things, like you know, the local, the places that they could go to, the local services that would be offered.
¿Cuál puede ser una metodología de intervención?
And what could be a method of intervention?
Y la reconstrucción del tejido social con los
and the rebuilding of the social fiber.
Los jóvenes. ¿Cuáles fueron los resultados? Bueno, fue muy interesante.
So what were the results? And she said, well, it was very interesting.
Interesante, ya que además de que les explicamos en qué consistía este programa.
And then after we explained what this program consisted of,
se les sensibilizó sobre la fragmentación del tejido y cómo nos podríamos articular con actores locales para mejorar esta convivencia comunitaria. Ellos expresaron, que también fue muy importante.
So she said they talked about how they would be able to work on this to, like, maybe have actors kind of do a scene on it so that they can help in the future, so that, you know, to help people not, I guess, be involved in this gas thievery, because, again, you know, this very risky behavior. Not only can they lose their lives, but if they get caught doing it, there is no bond. You cannot be bailed out or a bond paid. It's considered a grave crime to steal gas. Not only because these people died, but because it was very bad for the economy, the way they were stealing. And it was causing a lack of enough resources to be able to supply the needs of the people.
El trauma por la explosión y los efectos en el municipio.
And so they were helping them to deal with the trauma of the explosion and the municipal areas.
Así como el peso del estigma.
So also the weight of the stigma of that explosion,
que recae sobre afectados, familias y municipio,
which falls upon the people, the family members, and anyone who lives in that municipality.
Se identificó y reflexionó sobre cómo estas dinámicas de fragmentación pueden irse superando a través de ejercicios de articulación con.
So they talked to them about how they can overcome these problems that they're going to deal with socially, talking about it and different coping mechanisms.
Actores locales y que pueda haber realmente incidencia a través de acciones específicas a nivel de familia, barrio, escuela, trabajo e iglesias.
So they were going to have them dealing with it, family, school, work of churches and religious communities to help them deal with this stigma.
La que sigue. Asimismo, ellos manifestaron el abandono histórico por parte de autoridades asociado tanto al.
And so they had said that they felt that they had been abandoned by the previous authorities historically.
Luchas políticas como sociales.
And that this was also involving politics and social situations.
Y lograron ellos recuperar en la memoria también la capacidad de participación y solidaridad comunitaria.
And so they were able to put into their memory the participation and solidarity of the past.
A través de lo que ellos llaman las faenas, que a través de las cuales construyen y rehabilitan espacios públicos.
So by this they are rebuilding and restructuring public places in order to have a place to have more social interaction
de su comunidad.
In their community.
Se identificó que era necesario sumar más jóvenes, ya que
they identified that they needed to add more youth into these programs.
Hay una preocupación en esta comunidad.
And they had this preoccupation in this community.
Por el consumo de drogas y de alcohol.
Because of the consumption of drugs and alcohol.
Alcohol, así como el uso de celulares y otras tecnologías.
And also the use of cell phones and other technologies.
Que los alejan de otro tipo de actividades.
And these things kind of distance them from other activities that might be good for them.
Productivas a los jóvenes y de compromiso social. Y se prevé que justamente a partir del 2020 ya podamos iniciar con este programa de reconstrucción social.
And so they believe that in the year 2020 they are going to be working and being able to do something for the social moral fiber repair of this community.
De una manera formal y con una metodología específica.
With a formal and specific method.
Con estas familiares.
For these particular families.
La que sigue. Hubo también apoyo en el ámbito cultural, brigadas culturales sobre.
So we also had support by the culture and community support, and they had brigades.
De todo que ayudaron posteriormente al evento.
And they helped after the event.
En los procesos resilientes de estudiantes.
In helping the students become resilient and return to school.
Sobre todo de educación básica.
Especially with basic education.
Fueron actividades como danza, música, teatro, artes plásticas.
They had theater, dancing, plastic arts.
151 actividades. Entre
they had 151 activities.
30 escuelas públicas.
In 30 public schools.
Con 17 profesionales especializados. Y
and they had 17 professionals that were specialized in this.
Lograron capacitar 132 docentes de estas escuelas públicas de educación básica para
and they were able to do this in 132 schools, basically.
Que ellos tengan estas mismas herramientas y las
so that they could have the same materials available to them or tools.
Las puedan replicar con sus alumnos.
So that they could also replicate it in other places with their students. Or tragedies, I guess.
Aquí vemos las fotos, la que sigue.
And here you can see the picture.
También con el programa de Jóvenes Construyendo el Futuro se está.
And also with the program of Youth Creating the Future.
Estableció el programa Fortaleciendo la Protección Civil. Se firmó un convenio con la Coordinación Nacional de Protección Civil.
And they formed a convenio, like a committee that collaborated on the 25th of February with the National Protection for Civilians, Secretary of Work, and Social Provision. Applied tutors for more than 150 municipalities, and they had areas of presence near the where the pipelines were dug. There was a plan of capitization, elaboration of the school system, And they had 18, on the 18th of March, they had a process of inscription for the youth on these platforms. I'm going to go to the next part. Since they're putting it in writing, I can just read and translate that. Okay, there we go.
Distribuyeron 47 cápsulas informativas.
So she said they distributed 47 informative capsules. Let's see, they had 23 municipalities. They had public talks. There was 8,927 in one, and 11,779 had materials that were given to them. They had let's see, public for they had services for the babies or infants. To give them information of the different phenomenons and things that could be scary for them or perturbant. They had certification of people that were titled in the protection of civilians. Let's see, and they were there according to their risk and elaborated on the risks of being involved in these or near these pipelines and gas and, you know, being involved in accessing these pipelines, you know. The price of gas has gotten so bad that people, you know, are always looking away to for a way to get it free or make money at it themselves. So this is one of the ways that Mexicans were making it a living when there was no help from the government. There was no government assistance. They had no education. They weren't allowed jobs, or they had no jobs. And so people turned to this, and unfortunately, there was a great tragedy. And so they gave them informational videos on the tragedies that could happen with combustibles so that they could learn.
230 infografías y también que la gente se ponga a salvo, que desde luego denuncie también de inmediato si.
Okay, so here this might be a little bit important because they talk about what you could do if you find out. See, this is where they're siphoning the gas. Okay, let's go back a little bit. That looks quite interesting.
Pues bueno, es una muestra de el material que se fue desarrollando para generar conciencia.
Okay, well,
hubo campañas
like
diversas, sobre todo en.
Goodness. Oh, there it is. It's like a little video they have. Okay.
Si no, pues está, si
there's
no.
A video. I guess this was right after the explosion.
No solo es lo que pierde la nación.
It's not just what the nation loses.
With comercio ilegal,
illegal commerce,
sino
but also
la pérdida de vidas humanas.
Human
el manejo inapropiado de combustibles puede ocasionar explosiones e incendios para
okay.
quien lo transporte.
It said the inappropriate use of incendiary products, which are combustibles, and them being stored and in a unacceptable manner could be very dangerous.
Transporta o almacena de manera inadecuada.
So this is where they're storing them in an inadequate way. So see, they would steal the gas and put it in these containers and just store it somewhere.
Su robo y comercialización te pone en riesgo a ti.
And they say the theft and commercialization puts you at risk.
A tu familia,
and your family.
Y a los servidores públicos.
And the public servants that are attending to the emergencies.
Que atienden la emergencia. Tú puedes ayudar a combatir al huachicol.
And they said you could help to combat huachicol. Huachicol is the word. Now huachicol, in the reason they use this word in Mexico and many other countries, they had like a kind of like a device that would collect water. You know, like a little ladle. Like a ladle, that might be the word for it. Ladle, and then with a ladle, they would collect the water and put it in their cisterns. And so, This is kind of what they would do. They would bust into the pipes and then they would collect the gas like if they were doing it with a ladle. So probably the word ladle would be the most appropriate for guachicol, and they would that's what they would call that when you did the I'm sorry, I've got somebody walking through my house here where I'm trying to record and I'm hearing a lot of noise. Excuse me. So sorry, Mom was listening. She wanted to say goodbye. All right, and so it says if you see a gas leak or someone taking gas illegally, which they call clandestine take, then report it to 911 because number one, you could be at risk. You know, it could explode.
Y a construir una nueva historia.
And to construct a new life.
Pues bueno, es una muestra del material que se fue desarrollando para generar conciencia.
And so this is to show you the material that was given in order to generate a conscious and make them more conscious of what is possible and what could occur.
Campañas diversas, sobre todo en temas de no participar en el robo de combustible.
And also to encourage them not to participate in the theft of combustibles.
Que no se compre ni comercialice, que la
and do not buy or sell it.
La gente se ponga a salvo, que desde luego
and if you see it, make yourself go to a safe place.
Denuncie también de inmediato, si sabe.
And to let it be known right away. Report it.
O conoce de estas prácticas.
If you know about these practices.
Y de no exponer a la familia.
And not expose your family.
Bueno, el día de mañana, que pues ya a un año de estos hechos, se está primero programando aquí en la ciudad un evento conmemorativo que es un foro.
So they're going to be doing a commemoration there in the city, which is a forum.
Sobre riesgos asociados al manejo de combustibles con diferentes temas para.
Regarding the combustibles and other matters like that.
Para seguir generando esta conciencia.
So they could continue to encourage this conscience about this.
De prevención y del riesgo que implica.
Regarding prevention and the risk that it implies.
Y así mismo estamos previendo también el día de mañana a las 10.
And in the same way we're viewing tomorrow.
A las 10:30 de la mañana.
At 10:30 in the morning.
En el lugar de los hechos.
At the place of the occurrence.
Acompañar a los familiares.
And to accompany the family members.
A las 10:30 de la mañana.
At 10:30 in the morning.
Para rememorar estos sucesos, reflexionar con ellos y también.
To commemorate these things that happened and commiserate with them.
En memoria, pues, de todos los que perdieron su vida.
In remembrance of all of those that lost their lives.
Así que este es el informe, desde luego, como comentó el presidente.
And so this was the information that the president said. Okay, so now we're going to have, let's see if we can see the president start to talk. Okay, there's going to be another guy talking. It looks like they got a video.
El gobierno municipal, el gobierno estatal y el gobierno gasolina y gas tiene que ver con que el combustible es muy difícil de controlar.
So they said part of the problem is that combustibles are very hard to control.
¿Pudieran poner el primer video que les hice llegar? Esa es una fuga de gas LP en el municipio de Nextlalpan, estado.
And there they're showing a leak of the gas that's LP, which is the type that is the one they used in the home in the little tank barbecue.
De México son las primeras horas del día esa.
And this was early in the morning.
La nube
que and that cloud that you see
que se ve es gas LP, es decir,
it's LP gas.
Tuvimos un recorrido de la Sedena, es un evento del año pasado, del mes de agosto.
And this happened in the month of August last year.
Ubican la toma clandestina descontrolada.
And so what they found was that a clandestine or a illicit connection or how shall I say, they were trying to tap into the line and it got out of control for them.
Por supuesto, de inmediato corre todo el protocolo de protección.
So of course we started the protocol of protection.
Civil en el cual participan, como ustedes saben, el gobierno municipal, el gobierno estatal y el gobierno.
So all forms of government, state, municipal, and federal came to help.
De México. El gas LP viene dentro del ducto. Este es un ducto que corre desde Reforma Chiapas hasta Zapotlanejo, Jalisco.
So this one runs under the city and it runs from Reforma to Chiapas, I think he said.
Jalisco es el Cactus Guadalajara. El ducto trae gas LP a alta presión dentro del ducto.
And that duct brings high pressure gas in that pipeline.
Es líquido en el momento que se libera, que hay una toma clandestina.
So where they try to get it, it's liquid, but then
baja la presión y se
as the pressure drops, it
convierte en gas y se multiplica cientos de veces al salir.
And it multiplies hundreds of times as it comes out.
Con la salida del sol, el gas se disipa de manera rápida.
And if the sun comes out, the gas dissipates rapidly.
Pero en temperaturas frías y en ausencia de luz solar,
but in cold temperatures and in the absence of light,
se precipita al
it
piso
precipitates
y se vuelve
to the floor.
Muy complicado que nosotros podamos controlarlo.
And then it becomes very difficult for us to control it.
Como sucedería con una toma de gasolina, de un combustible líquido, donde podemos hacer tal vez una zanja de.
And they say it's different from when they take the liquid gasoline, where we could perhaps make a ditch and divert the gas.
Y con un vector ir tomando el combustible y recuperarlo.
And maybe we could, you know, get some kind of a suction device and recover some of the gas, but with this.
En este caso tenemos que usar brisa con las pipas de los bomberos.
And then we have to use like a spray with the pipes from the fire department.
Municipales, estatales y del gobierno federal para abrir una brecha o acorralar el gas.
And so we have to try to corral gas because it needs to flow by itself.
Que las familias puedan hacer una evacuación.
And then the families would be able to evacuate.
Es importante comentar también que el gas LP sale a muy bajas temperaturas.
And so it's also important to note that the LP gas comes out at a very low temperature.
Lo que congela el terreno.
And this will freeze the land.
Y es muy difícil para los compañeros de Petróleos Mexicanos que hacen un trabajo extraordinario.
And it is very difficult for the people, the petroleum workers who do a very excellent job.
El poder ubicar el punto de fuga por
to be able to find the point of escape.
Que el terreno se congela y tenemos que romper ese terreno.
Because the land becomes frozen and we have to break it.
Con maquinaria, por supuesto.
With machinery.
Puesto sin provocar una chispa.
Without provoking any sparks.
Algo que a estos grupos delincuenciales les lleva unas horas, ese proceso para nosotros dura algunos días.
And for what takes them a few hours to cause the problem, it takes us a few days to fix it.
El protocolo marca que en cuanto se ubica la fuga, ya sea por una denuncia o por, repito, un recorrido.
But if it happens that we find a leak because maybe somebody reported it or something is happening.
De las Fuerzas Armadas, por supuesto, hacemos un cerco de seguridad.
Or maybe it's found by the monitoring of armed forces, then we have to do a call an alarm.
Hacemos una evacuación y
and we evacuate.
Es un proceso de ubicación del punto de fuga en el ducto y de reparación.
And then we have to start searching where the point of the leak is and start reparations.
Ese proceso en el punto del gas es complicado porque vamos corriendo.
And that process in the point of the gas is very complicated.
Corriendo contra el tiempo.
Because you're fighting against time.
¿Podrían poner el siguiente video?
And he said, could you put on the next video?
Por favor, el segundo que les pasé.
The second.
Este, sin que le pongan play todavía, es también un, esto es en Acajete, en el estado de Puebla, también en.
So this was in the state of Puebla.
Gas LP.
This is also LP gas leak.
Nosotros comenzamos a trabajar en la mañana a ubicar el punto de fuga.
And in the morning we started to go to find the leak.
Se cierran de inmediato válvulas.
And we closed valves right away.
En el ducto adelante y
ahead and after the leak.
Y atrás siempre queda un remanente de combustible.
There's always a remnant of the combustible.
Dentro del ducto que
within the duct or pipeline.
Es el que se está disipando, es el que ven ustedes que se está.
And that is the one that is dissipating, the one you can see here.
Está disipando. Las válvulas no están cerca una de otras. Hay.
And these valves are not near one to the other.
Kilómetros entre.
There's kilometers in between them.
Ellas es como cuando cerramos la llave del jardín de nuestra manguera, siempre queda agua dentro, aunque ya. No.
He says it's just like when you turn off your water hose. There's always still water in the hose.
No hay, está abierta la llave. Eso mismo sucede en el ducto.
And the same thing happens in the pipeline or duct.
Cuando comenzamos a trabajar en el día, el gas se disipa, pero si se viene la noche.
And if we start to work in the day, the gas will dissipate, but if we're working at night.
Baja la temperatura.
Then the temperature will drop.
No hay luz solar.
And there's no light.
No podemos controlar.
Then we cannot control
ese gas. Entonces tenemos que, de manera controlada, prenderle fuego a esa toma.
And so then what we have to do is in a controlled manner turn light the fire in order to destroy the gas.
Clandestina, garantizando por supuesto que no exista población cerca. Y
and we have to guarantee that there is no population nearby.
Justamente para que el gas remanente se esté quemando y no
so that the remnant gas can be burning.
Ponga en riesgo a la población que se encuentra cercana.
And it will not put at risk the people that are nearby.
Todo esto pone en riesgo, por supuesto, a las familias mexicanas, pero
and all of this puts the Mexican families at risk.
También a una serie de servidores públicos extraordinarios que trabajan.
And it also puts the public servants that are extraordinary at risk as well.
Trabajan en esto, soldados, marinos, guardias nacionales, bomberos municipales, y no se diga los compañeros de Petróleos Mexicanos que hacen la labor directamente en el ducto. Si quiere ponerle play, por favor.
Ya le estamos acometiendo.
Ahí está el apoyo de los soldados, por supuesto, de las unidades de protección civil.
Y espero saludarte pronto.
Iba a ir yo a. Oh my God, that's where they lit it.
Y en el proceso se le lanza un dardo.
Oh, and then they put a dart in there.
Con una punta incandescente. Al punto de fuga, y lo que ven ahora ustedes es,
so they light it.
Imaginemos el piloto de la estufa de nuestra
like
cocina, imaginemos el piloto del calentador de gas de nuestra casa, el gas remanente se está quemando,
the
ese remanente que
burn.
Continúa en, dentro del ducto tal vez nos
the
lleva a que se queme un día, dos días, en cuanto termina el gas,
down.
En cuanto se quema todo ese gas remanente, los compañeros de Pemex se acercan y hacen la reparación del ducto y se pone una vez más el ducto en operación. Cuando tenemos una mayor fortuna en el manejo de este tipo de tomas, de inmediato se logra ubicar el punto de fuga en esa nube de gas que ustedes ven y los compañeros de Pemex la cierran sin tener que hacer este procedimiento. Pero esta es nuestra última salida para evitar que llegue la noche, el gas corra entre las colonias y las familias se puedan ver.
That they would do if there was remnant gas in the nightfall was coming on them. They would have to do it before the night fell. Very interesting. Hey, Alex, Marco. Thank you for stopping in. Okay, you guys, let me see the next part. The president is going to talk now.
Diana y un grupo de servidores públicos en Tlahualilpan van a estar con los familiares, con la comunidad, con todo el pueblo. Llevan nuestro pésame.
So he says they're going to be having a meeting over there with them, and they're going to be letting them know of their condolences. Okay, let's see what else is on there.
Pues están ahí porque buscan sobrevivir, buscan un ingreso, buscan un apoyo.
And he says they were doing that because they were looking for a way of life. They were looking for a way to make a living, and so they were going there and taking that risk, that gas line.
Y sus familiares, pues lo mismo, ¿no? O sea, ellos merecen todo nuestro apoyo, toda nuestra solidaridad. Y así va a seguir siendo, nada más que se vaya tomando conciencia de que estas actividades no deben de prevalecer. Nada de esta informalidad debe de prevalecer. Agradecer mucho al gobierno de Hidalgo, al gobernador en especial, Omar Fayad, porque desde que se presenta esta tragedia, desde que se da a conocer lo que había sucedido, él se traslada con un grupo de servidores públicos del gobierno de Hidalgo y está ahí pendiente.
So he's talking about somebody that was there.
Y ha actuado de manera responsable.
And has acted in a very responsible way that went and helped the people as soon as they knew there was a fire.
Yo hablo de que Hidalgo tiene muchas tomas clandestinas, pues no es culpa, responsabilidad solo del gobierno de Hidalgo, es responsabilidad también y sobre todo del gobierno federal, nosotros, o sea, y de la lucha que tenemos con los que se dedican a estas actividades ilícitas. Pero no es echarle la culpa, ¿no?, a un gobierno estatal. Son circunstancias, volvemos a lo mismo. Entonces, terminamos con esto. Quiero aprovechar dos cosas. Ofrezco, no el lunes, pero el martes. Que se han hecho con la participación de las comunidades, 26 caminos de concreto.
They've made 26 roads
que han hecho las comunidades, hemos apoyado nosotros destinándoles el dinero,
and we give them the money.
Ellos han administrado este dinero
and they administer the money.
Con el trabajo de los miembros de la comunidad, de hombres y de mujeres, con su conocimiento, su creatividad, han hecho caminos bellísimos, artesanales. Vamos a informar sobre eso, ahora en la gira no tengo el dato. No se han hecho los caminos como se acostumbraba, con empresas contratistas, caminos de asfalto, sino de concreto.
So he says it's not
y
like
se
the
logra
street.
Un efecto multiplicador.
Okay, so what happened is they used to hire these companies to make an asphalt road, and what they would do is they would put a very thin layer of asphalt so that they could keep a bigger amount of the money that they got. And so then when the rain would come, they would wash the roads away. So these streets that they're making now, that they give the indigenous communities, and all the different communities that they give it to, they give them the money directly. They give them the cement, and then they put rocks, and they make these beautiful, artisan style roads. They have one row of cement, and then rocks, and then cement, and so they're very sturdy, and they withhold. When even when the rainy season, it's very interesting. I saw a video on that. I did a video on that if you'd like to watch it.
Se da trabajo, muchos empleos en las comunidades. Queda el dinero en las comunidades, en los municipios, en las regiones. Se reactiva la economía regional y se hace la obra. Es muy importante esto. Y ya de los más de 100 frentes que abrimos en Oaxaca, ya hay 26 caminos terminados. A eso vamos, vamos a la Mixteca.
So he said they've given more than 100, or they've planned to do more than 100 roads, but so far they've finished 26, and they're going to be going to see them.
Y también a comunidades zapotecas vamos a inaugurar estos caminos. Entonces,
so they're going to go inaugurate these roads.
Me tengo que ir a las 8:30, pero
so they're going to do it today. So maybe today after I get off work I can come and do a video about those where they're going to be doing the inauguration of these roads. Alas, I have to go to work. So I'm going to have to stop the video here. Thank you very much, Beatriz, for visiting, and also Alex for visiting today with me and keeping me entertained on my chat. I appreciate everything. Thank you. I'm going to have to go, though. I have to go to work. But I made a promise that I was going to do a video every day. And so this is two. I did the first one about the president. I did a little short one. The president said that they had approved, the Senate had approved the Temec agreement, and it was just a little brief one, but I wanted to do one that showed a little bit more about the conference. Unfortunately, I will not be able to finish the conference today, but we'll see what happens when I get off work. Thanks a lot. Have a great day. Thank you, Beatriz. Adios.